Hello and welcome to the heart of Siberia, Russia. We're in the city of Tumen for the 2021 UIAA Ice Climbing World Youth Championships. Now, we had a bit of a technical glitch earlier, which meant, unfortunately, we weren't able to show the youth female speed finals. But we're going to go straight into the action now with the youth males. And this is Vladislav Turba in the under 16 category. Just 14 years old. And the ice is like concrete. It's been so cold here, as low as minus 30 degrees. And you get a sense of just how bullet hard it is. But he's doing extremely well. And he gets the top, 20.41 seconds. It's really, really great to be here in Tumen. It's the first time UIAA have had a tour stop here. But of course, the city is no stranger to ice climbing action. So next up is Maxim Semikov. Just 13 years old. And he's already got the technique dialed. Very short arm reach. I've had the technique explained to me as like an insect. You want to think of, be like an insect. Your arms are going off at an angle, slightly closer to the body than conventional ice climbing. That was a tremendous ascent there from Semikov. When I looked at the thermometer earlier, it was minus 20. So spare a thought for these very young climbers. David Mamin is off. That's a very explosive start from the young Russian. Very good technique, no mistakes. Every pick is holding. It's looking very good indeed. You'll be very happy with that. Big smile, 15.17 seconds. So yes, it's been extremely cold here, even by Russian standards. Over the last few days, it's been as low as minus 30. So I don't think the servers like that very much. We had a little bit of a technical glitch this morning, so I do apologize about that. The next up is Mikhail Seselishin, 13 years old, very fast start. Got the technique dialed nicely. Just got to see what the time will be on this. That should put him into the lead. 13.54 seconds from Mikhail Seselishin. This is Dmitry Muzalevsky, another very young climber, just 13. Good start, just lost the footing there. Oh, did very well to hang on. It's quite challenging. It is extremely hard, this ice. Very brittle. So he is doing extremely well to stay on the route. The ladies had a few falls, so just staying on the route is impressive. Can he get the top? He does. 35.5 seconds. It's Still, it's not about the time at this age. It's about whether you're having fun. Making sure that they enjoy themselves and help develop their potential as they progress through the years. Being aged only 13, he's potentially got 7 years ahead of him in the youth championships alone. So we've got India's only athlete taking part. This is Aviram Simhaswarup, who is from Delhi. Notice the slightly different technique to the Russians. Oh, and he's off. Yeah, he's just learnt the hard way that you really can't swing your tool into this ice. This discipline is all about just finding the placements and just hooking. You want to place that pick in a pre-existing hole. Doesn't always work in practice, however. Still, Aviram still has two more attempts to go, so he shouldn't be disheartened. Now, last up is Roman Shubin, 13 years old, younger brother of Pavel. He was fifth last year at the Youth Championships in Kirov, so we can expect good things from him. Makes a very solid start, looking very good. Oh, did he get the top? He did, 12 seconds exactly, which puts him into the lead. So Roman Shubin is currently in the number one spot with that flawless ascent there. Over a second faster than Mikhail Seysalishyatin. So we're straight on to the boys under 19. Maxim Reshetnikov makes an explosive start on his first of three routes. 9.60, very fast indeed. He was third at the under 19s last year. So definitely one to watch. And next we've got our only Kyrgyzstani athlete, Isa Konushbayev, 17 years old. One tool in the ice, one foot in the ice, ready to go. And he's off. Did well to hang on there. Just slows it down. Tries to regain control. And it's here that you actually get a sense of just how challenging it is. Some of the more proficient climbers make it look easy. It's not. And he is off. Disappointing, but still two more ascents to go. Just couldn't quite keep his purchase on the ice there. So Artem Shevrev, seventh last year, 16 years old. He's poised, coiled, ready to launch, and it's a very fast ascent. Very efficient, just got to make sure no mistakes. Can he get all the way to the top? That could be a very fast time, 9.390, and that puts him into number one. It could be quite a fierce battle amongst these youth males. Very impressive ascent there from Shevrev. So this is me, Ehrman Siginti, from Kazakhstan. his first time competing in the World Youth Championships. Just making sure those tool placements are good. Kick with the legs. Make sure those picks are in somewhere that's going to hold. So that even if the legs just skit out, you're still on the route. Because the most important thing is to top. And he does it. Not going to be a winning time. 37.2 seconds. But that doesn't matter. So Nikolai Maslov, he was fourth last year in the under-19s, so can he get on the podium this time around? It's a fast start, looking good, lost the right foot there, done well to recover, very good technique, arms right off to the side, little bit of a stumble, 11.2, fast, but not as fast as Maxim Reshetnikov. But it does put him into third place for now. It can be a cruel sport, speed climbing. Sometimes you can have absolute perfect, flawless technique and you're just unlucky. Ice breakages is all part of the game. So this now is Danila Naumov. Second last year. One to watch, if you can keep up. That was a flying start. Oh no, and he's off. Just goes to show, such an unforgiving sport. He started absolutely like a rocket. Very, very fast. And it looked like the right arm just popped. Danila Bikulov is the last athlete up. He's been competing since 2017. And he won the Champagne last month, so he can compete with the best of them. And unfortunately, he's not going to win with an ascent like that. Just goes to show, I was just saying he won Champagne last month of the European Championship stop. And then at the youth, doesn't work out. Still, two more rounds to go. Now on to under 21s. And this is Ivan Lushenko. A good start from Ivan. It's not the fastest ascent that we've seen today, but he will be happy with that. He gets the top. 12.25 seconds. He was fifth last year in Kirov, so he'll be hoping that perhaps he can get on the podium this time around. Let's see. Two more rounds to go for him. Next up is the 20-year-old Ilya Karuchkin. Now, amazingly been competing for 7 years. And it shows, look at the experience. Oh, and he gets his pick stuck. Does well to recover. Lost a lot of time there, 12.19 seconds. Still a very, very dangerous and threatening athlete. Puts him into second place. Now this man is Nikita Glazarin, a four-time youth speed champion. Can he make it a fifth? His final year competing for the Youth Championships. What's he got for us today? 10.35 seconds. That puts him into the number one spot, which is where he likes to be. His debut was way back in 2015. He came third in the under-16s. So, Pavel Versov from Kazakhstan.
Ready. Attention.
Just the foothills of the Tian Shan Mountains. First time competing the Youth Games. And here a few cries of Dubai, Dubai, the Russian for go, go, go. So far, so good. Not quite as fast as Glazarin, but 19 seconds. He'll be happy with that. Puts him into fourth place. Who knows? Maybe podium next round. Managed to stay on the ice, which is the most important thing in this discipline. But this is Igor Volkov, 19 years old. Oh, did very well to hang on there. Mistake right at the start. So he's done well to recover. Keep going. Good technique. 14.65 seconds for Volkov. Fifth last year in the under-19s. Still two more rounds to go. The route is quite high as ice routes go, about 12 meters. So Vladislav Temerev, 18 years old, from Siberia. So this man will know, you're no stranger to the cold, and he seems completely unfazed by it as he makes a very fast ascent. Lightning, absolute lightning, 9.8 seconds, and that puts him into the top. He was second in the under 16 in 2017. We've got one more athlete to come from the under 21s, and that is Igor Zinoviev. We saw him last month competing in Champagny. He came ninth. Let's see what he's got for us today. Good start. Fast out of the blocks. Oh, lost his left leg there. Did well to cling on with the right, and in leaps and bounds makes it to the top in 11.5. Not quite, yes, that's third place, just onto the podium for now. So currently the fastest times after that first round, Temerev, Glazarin, and Zinoviev. But anything can still happen. Yeah, look, we can really get a sense of just how cold it is when you're seeing the judges and officials jumping up and down on the spot. Of course, Russians are no stranger to cold temperatures, but even the last few days, I've been told, it's been particularly harsh. Yesterday, it was minus 30. It's so cold that your eyelids can just freeze shut. You've got to keep blinking. I did speak to one of the event officials and said, you know, how does it affect performance? He said, don't worry, they're Russian. But of course it does affect performance. Got to keep warm. But the main thing affects is the quality of the ice. At these temperatures, the ice is very brittle. and prone to snapping off. So we're back to the under-16s with Vladislav Torba, 14 years old. Did well to cling on for dear life there. Once again, clinging on. Just got to make the top. Not quite. Can he do it? There he is in 20.92 seconds for Torba. So just half a second slower than his previous ascent. Maxim Semikov.
Ready? Attention.
19 seconds is the time to beat. His previous time on the first round. Looking good so far for this young Russian athlete. .24.58, 6 seconds slower. You can see some of these youngsters are wearing knee pads. There's been some discussion of having protection for speed climbers. David Mamim, one of the youngest athletes competing today. But by the look of it, I was going to say proficient, but just at that point he fell off and he's very disappointed. Just lost his arm there. So he's just got his one time of 15.17 seconds. So Mikhail Sesolishyatin is up next. Previous time was 13.54. Doing well so far. Good technique. Picks are mostly sticking. And that gives him a time of 15.26. And into second place. You can really see the explosive moves there from the legs, leaping up. It's all about dynamic movement. Dmitry Muzilevsky next, 13 years old. Did well to hang on there, a bit of a barn door swing from him. He keeps moving the feet, getting the picks in. Hanging in there. Previous time. The time, that 32.259. Previous time was 35.54. 3 seconds quicker. That's an improvement. That's all we're looking for. As the late alpinist Alex Lowe once said, the best climber is the one having the most fun. So Avram Simas Swarup, one of only a handful of athletes who are not from Russia. He's come all the way from Delhi to take part. You don't see so many Indian climbers competing And he'll be disappointed. He's just come off there. Very disappointing. That's two falls he has had. Shakes his head in disbelief. Very unlucky for a young Indian climber. It would seem that locals definitely do have an advantage in this sport. Roman Ashubin, 13 years old. And already got that lovely lolloping style. Going for the big reaches. Just gets his pick stuck. Will that cost him? He's 16.4. Not his fastest time, but he's still in first place. So 4 seconds slower than his previous round, but still in the number one spot for now. Everything's still to play for with one more round to go. So we now move to the under 19s. Maxim Reshetnikov. Currently second, 9.6 seconds. That's the time he needs to beat to improve his last round. 9.39 seconds is the time to beat. Is he going to do it? Not on this round. 16.17 seconds. Still, he got a time. He got on the scoreboard. They're currently second in the rankings. There, the judges. Big shout out to them. They do pretty thankless task standing in the cold. So, Isa Konoshbaev from Kyrgyzstan, from Bishkek. Just tries to get a good placement there with the left. So the starting position, one axe in the ice, 1 foot on the ice. And that's a very fast start. Very explosive indeed. He's carrying on as he intends. And this could be a winning time. It's looking good. 11.20. But it just gets him into fifth position. So Artem Shevarev, next up. So he got the fastest time the last time around, 9.39 seconds. That's the time to improve upon. And it's a pretty steady start. It's not going to be as fast, anything like as fast as his first round. Seems to have almost just got stuck there on that little problem. Feet not sticking. This is almost twice as slow as his previous ascent. Excuse me, it's Miriamman Sagantay. That will be why it's not quite as fast as his previous ascent. My mistake. From Kazakhstan. 34 seconds for the Kazakh athlete. So Nikolai Maslov next up. Making a very fast start, but it all comes off, doesn't work out for the young 17-year-old. His fourth last year in Kirov, but very disappointed. So Danila Naumov is next up. Just gets his arms into position. Fast start. Can he maintain the speed? Despite the mistakes and the little stops, it's looking pretty good. ...11.78 seconds. And now I'm off. Danila Bikulov next. Now he's hoping just to get on the scoreboard. He fell on his first round. So far, so good. Oh, and a dynamite acceleration there through the middle part of this route. Very fast at the top. Very fast indeed. 9.39 seconds. And that definitely puts him into contention if he can get on the scoreboard on his third route. So,
ready? Attention.
Looking very fast here for the Russian athlete. 10.74 seconds for Ivan Lyshenko. Currently leaves him in third place. Next up, Ilya Krutchkin. Second last year. Currently lying in fourth place. Poised and ready to launch. Looking fast. Just look at the speed of those legs. Slight mistake, didn't get the top. Got to hit the mat. 11.5 seconds, lost just a fraction of a second getting the mat, but faster than his previous. Three tenths of a second faster. So next, Nikita Glazarin. Currently lying in second place, doesn't have the fastest time. Let's see what he can do on his second ascent. Fast. 9.97 seconds. Still leaves him in second place at the moment. Pavel Bursov from Kazakhstan. 19 seconds was his last time. Let's see if he can be a little bit quicker this time around. He's staying connected to the ice, which is always a bonus, and can't be taken for granted. So he is doing very well just to stay in the fight, and he's fighting hard. Ah, but doesn't make it, falls just near the top. So disappointing for the Kazakh athlete. Just saw his, couldn't get his right in there, but I think it was the left that just popped. Just inches, almost within touching distance of the finishing. Matt didn't quite get it. So Igor Volkov, 19-year-old from Siberia, showing us how it's done. Very, very well done for him to stay connected to the ice. Two big falls. He knows it's over, but he can at least get a score. 20.8 for the Siberian Volkov. So it doesn't leave him in contention for the podium at the moment. He really needs to pull one out of the bag on his third ascent if he's to have any chance of getting into the top three. Temerev. Very fast indeed for the Russian athlete. 9.530 seconds. That should leave him safely in the first position. Just a flawless technique there. No mistakes. Igor Zinoviev now is the final climber. Very fast indeed. Let's see. Can he get up there without making any mistakes? Without any stops? And he's hit an obstacle. He knows it's not a winning performance, but just to get on the scoreboard is important for Zinoviev. And he does 16.38 seconds, which leaves him in fifth place. A little bit slower than his first round. Almost 5 seconds slower. It just goes to show you do need a little bit of luck in this game. You can't rely on the conditions. Every time you go up, it can be different. And the route also changes its characteristics. A hold that you might have got on the first route might have broken off. So we're just having a look at the judges trying to stay warm, jumping around. It's minus 20 when I last checked the weather, the thermometer. And the judges do a fantastic job. All the volunteers who make this happen. Good to see them wearing the outdoor research jackets. We couldn't, this event couldn't happen without our sponsors, particularly Outdoor Research. Interestingly, they converted much of their production to making masks during the pandemic. And their support has been invaluable. Oh, there's a brave man. That's Rob Adey from the UIAA. Brave man taking a glove off, having to upload scores. So we should be now going back to the under 16s. And we are. This is Torba Vladislav for his third and final attempt. So currently in fifth place. Needs to do better than 20 seconds to improve his time. So he's just 14 years old, this lad. And already he's got the style, he's got the technique, he's fast. Let's see. 16.12 seconds. 4 seconds faster than his first two routes, so he'll be very happy with that. Third time lucky for Torba. It may not be enough, though, to see him on the podium. So, Maxim Semikov is next to demonstrate what he is capable of. Very fast with the arms and the legs. Amazing, just 13 years old. And what's he going to get? 17.7. Well, that's almost 7 seconds faster than his previous time. So well done to Semikov for shaving so much time off. Absolutely dialed that ascent. So David Mamim next up. So he had a fall last time around. So far, so good. Two very lucky escapes there. Going for the final stretch now. Gets the mat. 18.51 seconds. And that should leave him in third place, it does. So he will be very happy with that performance. First time, the youth championships. What a debut this young man has made. So, Mikhail Seysolishitin. Fast out of the blocks there. And so far making... I was going to say a flawless, but I didn't want to tempt fate, knowing that it might have done. Sadly, it's a fall, but Seysolishitin. However, he should still leave him in second place from his first two runs. He had 13.54 and 15.26, which does leave him currently in second place. Three more climbers to go, so he might not be safe yet. Especially if this lad has anything to do with it, Dmitry Muzalevsky.
Ready? Attention.
Disappointing. Right at the start, didn't get on the route. Very unlucky for the young 13-year-old. All over, he will finish. Perhaps not in last or second class. Now we have India's Abhiram Simhaswarup. Now he had two falls last time around, so he would just be hoping to stay on the route.
Ready?
Something not quite right. Just got to reset the timing map by the looks of it. So he assumes the position, which is 1 foot in the ice, one ice axe in the ice. So he just wants to stay on the ice. That's all he's got to do. It's a good swing with the arm. And falls again. Committed to the move when he just didn't have the feet holding him. But he's got a big smile. Three falls. Well, you know, that's the way it goes sometimes. So the most important thing, we've got a big smile from him. So hopefully he'll be back next year onto better things. So that wraps up the under 16s. So Roman Shubin looks like he's won that, but straight on to the male under 19s for Roman Shubin. Next up. Shubin making very, very fast progress on his third and final ascent. And that should, 14.75, not his fastest time. That was 12.07 seconds, but that should leave him in the lead. So now we go to the under 19s. Excuse me, my results feed is getting updated faster than my visual feed. So I'll try not to give the spoilers away. So Maxim Reshetnikov, very fast from this 17-year-old athlete. If he can just keep all the way going to the top, that will be an impressive time. 10 seconds almost exactly. Still, you've got to get sub 10 seconds really to win this. Both Chevrev and Bikulov have sub 10 second runs. But for the moment, Reshetnikov is in second place. Everything depends now on what happens with the rest of these athletes. You've got Issa. And this is Artem Chevrev. Very fast. Can he get there without any mistakes? Nine.86 seconds for Artem Chevrev. So next up is Miyamin Siginti. From Kazakhstan. Apologies for the technical error. We've got a little bit of an issue with some of the information coming on screen. So this is actually the Kazakh athlete, Miyamin Siginti. And he makes the top in 23.28 seconds. A little bit faster than his first two runs, almost 10 seconds faster, in fact. So if he can continue the improvement, he will be in podium place in a year's time. So Nikolai Maslov, 17-year-old, fourth last year in the under-19s. Explosive start, very dynamic. Just legs made of springs. Look at him go. No mistakes. 11.12 seconds. Which puts him into third place. With still a few more climbers to come. Next up is Danila Naumov. So 11.78 was his last time. Can he improve on that? Very fast start. No mistakes. That's what we're looking for from this young Russian. Very fast indeed. She gets to the top in a little bit of a stumble. 10.33 seconds. Not the fastest time, but absolutely flawless technique. Definitely a talent to watch. Danila Naumov. So Danila Bikulov, now this is a man to watch. He won last year, second the year before that. He won 2018 in the under 16s and was third back in 2017. Let's see what he can do. It's looking very fast indeed. Did well to hang on there. Can he recover? What's this going to be? Is it going to be sub 10 seconds? It is. It's 9.19 seconds, which almost guarantees that he will take the number one spot. Danila Bikulov goes into first place with a flawless ascent. Very fast indeed. 9.19 seconds for that run. 9.39 seconds for his previous run. Straight away gets the jacket on.
Ready? Attention.
So straight on now to under 21s. We've got Ivan Lyshenko. Ilya Kuryuchkin now. Very fast. For fighting his way all the way to the top there. From Kuryuchkin. Is that enough to get him onto the podium? 11.68 seconds. Probably not. Currently lying in fourth place. So Nikita Glazarin, what's he got in store for us today? What can this man do? Can he win again? He's won four times. It's fast, but I'm not sure if it's fast enough. 9.89 seconds, it might well be. But only gets him as far as second place. Still to come is Temerev, currently in the number one spot. But this is Pavel Fiasov, one of two athletes from Kazakhstan. And it's all over before it begins. That is a fall for the Kazakh athlete. Still, he at least manages a smile, and that's always good to see. Hopefully, we'll see him again. So Igor Volkov. So 14 seconds, 20 seconds were his first two times. So far, so good. But Volkov, a little bit of a stumble. Did well to get over that. Oh, that was close. Just swung out like a barn door, but just clung on for dear life. He gets a score, 15.96 seconds for him. It's not the fastest time for him, but he got three routes, which is better than some. And that should leave him probably in sixth place. With still two more athletes to come, and they are this man, Vladislav Temerev, 18-year-old, currently in the number one spot. What's he got for us on route number three? It's fast. It's looking really, really fast. Those legs are going like dynamos. 8.93. That is the fastest time we have seen today. And that seals his place into first place. Unless, of course, Igor Zinoviev can do something extraordinary, but I don't think so. I think Temerev almost certainly has won the gold there, and look at him, he's happy. He thinks so. It's in the bag for him. Celebrates there as he wins the under 21. But this is Igor Zinoviev. Can he get onto the podium? Dabai, dabai, you can hear them cry. Go, go, go. Looking good, looking very fast. Not 10.52 seconds, and that will give him third place onto the podium for Igor Zinoviev. with his fastest time, 6 seconds faster than his previous ascent. So absolute sterling performance there from this young 18-year-old. So there we go. That brings to an end the speed finals. So once again, an apology that we weren't able to cover the female athletes due to a technical glitch. But very happy that we brought you the male. So let's have a look at the leaderboard. So the under 16, it was Roman Shubin, Mikhail Seitalishitin, second place, and David Mamim, who takes third place. And in the under 19 males, it was in third place, Maxim Reshetnikov, second place, Artem Shevarev, and in first place, Danila Bikulov. And in the male under 21s, third place goes to Igor Zinoviev, second place to Nikita Glazarin, and first place to that Russian rocket, Vladislav Temerev. Now, don't go away. Stay tuned. We are also broadcasting the bouldering finals later today. So that will be super exciting. So stay tuned for that. And we shall see you shortly. Thanks for watching. We'll see you anon. Hey guys, we all good?